What up, what up, what up, ladies and gents? You are back with Mr. Harris on another one, another beautiful day. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for liking. Thank you for subscribing. Or thank you for disliking. So, this video here is going to be about the disconnect between black men and black women. And it's an idea that came to mind last night because I was checking out the video I did on Goldman Sachs investing $10 billion into black women. And I noticed I had got 100 views on it, but I got 12 dislikes and 2 likes. And I thought that was hilarious. I honestly felt honored, you know? Anyway, I was looking at the comments and you know, a couple females tried to come at me or whatever. And, you know, I don't give two F's about it. But I appreciate your opinion. I appreciate your perspective. I'm not going to sit here and go back and forth and, you know, it just is what it is. Let me say this. Even though I have black women that watch my channel and I appreciate you sisters being here, I say what I say mainly for black men. And I say what I say mainly for black men because black men are the one who is primarily behind enemy lines. Black men do not have billions of dollars being invested into them. Black men do not have the voice that black women have had over the last 10, 20, 30 years. And I know a lot of women are going to say, oh, well, that's because a black man didn't do this, didn't do that. No, we live in a white dominated society. And white society has been in rulership for quite some time. And they know the game better than we know the game. And they understand that the best divide to keep the black community at the lowest levels it's been at, where black women need $10 billion of investment, even though they've had years of subsidies and housing and education that have already been given to them by white society. Okay? Black women have more handouts than any other demographic of women. More than the Asians, because the Asian woman has her Asian man. More than the white woman, because the white woman is going off of her white man. The Latino woman, they may be kind of broke, but guess what? They got their Latino men. Black woman is the only woman that's separating themselves that need all these subsidies and handouts from white society by themselves. The Latino community does need these things as well, and they ask for them. But it's not the Latino woman by themselves. It's them and their husband and their family. And again, this is not a hate black woman channel. Let me tell you something. I don't give two craps about Goldman Sachs investing billions of dollars into anybody. And I said that in another video. I'm not here to get angry, get upset, spew hatred, nonsense. Women are beautiful, no matter what their ethnic group is. You know, me personally, I love a fine Latina woman. That's just me. But I love black women as well. But if we're honest, I believe that black women hold certain opinions and ideals that are detrimental to certain relationships. Not all, but a lot of them hold certain ideals that are detrimental overall to relationships, which make me hesitant in thinking long-term in that manner with a African-American woman like that. And it really depends upon her background, her social makeup, and all these things, her education, that would make me sway towards one side or the other. But again, this isn't about hating or being upset or being nasty with any type of woman. I say what I say for us men to get an understanding of where we're at in society. And for those women who want to listen and whether agree or disagree, put in their comments and say whatever they want to say, I'm all for it. I am all for it. We can have intellectual conversations about these things. Now, one commenter stated that black men are holding black women back. And I had to check her. I had to say, if you look at the Yahoo video, they singled out black men and black women, and it showed that black men on average hold a slightly higher net worth than black women do. It's slight, but black men are a little bit higher than black women. So obviously black men are not holding black women back. Black men are doing what they gotta do. Not all. But obviously our numbers on average are higher than black women's. So that argument is false. Black men cannot be holding black women back in that regard. And I said to her, this is 2021, not 1991. Nobody's holding anybody back. Everyone has the opportunity to succeed and win the way they feel and choose they need to. We're in the information, or we're passing the information age, where you can hustle and do what you gotta do, open businesses. There are plenty of black women who are killing it. There are plenty of black men who are killing it. On average, those numbers need to increase. But on both sides, there's people doing it. So no one is holding each other back. But what I'm saying is that the lack of unification between both men and the women of the black community keeps us in a position where we're relying on white society. You're reliant on their education. You're reliant on their billions of dollars. You're reliant on their social programs and all these other things. Because we're not unified, because we don't know how to come together and have these conversations without our women bringing in their educated. You're educated by white social standards. And if you understand society at a higher level, you understand that this education means nothing. That's why you have billion-dollar corporations such as Google, who is willing to hire people without their four-year degree, based upon show me what you can do, not tell me that you got a piece of paper. So your education means nothing. And unfortunately, our women are still using the same rhetoric. But again, this is not to be angry or upset or nasty at black women. This is for black men to get an understanding of where our community is at, where the minds of our women is at. Women are going to follow power. Women are going to follow the dominant hierarchy in society. Right now, that is the Caucasian man. And that is changing dramatically. They're on borrowed time. And so when that system collapses, black women are going to have to figure out what they're going to do. Heck, as I said before, they might go to the Asian man. Because the Asian man is going to be the new, at least for China, China-wise, the Asian man is going to rule. So at that point, we'll see how that goes. But that's why I stayed for myself, and I even told this to a woman I was talking to. I'm talking to now, or whatever we are. I said, I'm 30. I understand that my value as a man, I could be 50 and get a 25-year-old. I wouldn't marry her. But my whole premise for my life, if it came down to it, put in the work the next 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years, building my business, building my revenue income streams. Building my brand, take my assets, and then go to South America. Go where I see these men on YouTube who are dealing with women of a different caliber, a different spirit of humble means. And so they're operating a little bit differently. They're thinking a little bit differently. They're carrying themselves a little bit differently. Because I understand that women follow power. And when you go to a country like Brazil or Colombia, where the average standard of living is much lower, as a black man, you have assets, you saved up 100, 200, you don't have to be a millionaire. You go out there with 200, 300, 400K, as well as an income stream of $1,000 a month, and you go out there not to live off the system, but to build a business. You can live handsomely and have your picking and choosings. I don't say what I say to denigrate or put down the black woman. I say what I say because unfortunately, there is no saving the community. As long as things are the way they are, it's going to take a drastic change for things to shift. It's too easy for a woman to say divorce because she's bored or financial struggles or whatever the case may be, when we know that divorce rates are 80% initiated are by women. And again, I'm not saying that black men are perfect, because the rhetoric, and even I had my own moments where I was mad at black women. I was mad because I lacked understanding. I was mad because I was on child support and I didn't understand that the woman I chose to impregnate came from a broken home already. And I didn't see these flags enough to say, Josh, this is not the person you should be with. I was 23. And I understand that a lot of black men go through those angry moments where they're putting out these angry videos. My goal is to help us overcome that and see that that's foolish. My goal is to
help our women get an understanding. And most women, as well as men, on both sides,
will not get it.
Will not get it. That's why, for the single black woman, there are so many single mothers. That's why, for the black men, so many are on drugs, or broke,
or in jail, or act as a pookie and ray-ray, or want to be a thug. I think that narrative is definitely changing within us black men, glory be to God.
But that's why so many of us go down that path. Because the promotion, the message of what has been promoted in the community is ridiculous. Who we emulate, who we look at, who are supposed to be the leaders in the community. We're looking at basketball players. We're looking at rappers. We're looking at Cardi B. We're looking at The Stallion. These are the women that's glorified in the community. This is the music that's glorified in the community. And so, of course, we're all screwed up on both sides. So again, these videos are not to condemn or criticize a black woman just because she's a black woman. As men, we got to scrutinize ourselves first.
Once we change the dynamic of what we're willing to accept as men, everything else will change. Because I don't care what you black women say, most of the marriages are with black men. A minority are with interracial. A minority of men are willing to actually put a ring on your finger and sign that contractual obligation to put their lives on the line with you. Stop looking at TV. Stop looking at Hollywood. Go look at the numbers.
It's mainly black men who hold black women down. And unfortunately, whenever you're a black man and you got a little something going on for yourself and you're able to speak intellectually and